Before we start off our presentation, I would like to introduce my group members, myself, Melika, Zeling, Sharina, and Peter.
Customer able to buy online and company able to deliver straight to their doorstep. And the higher production cost because we have a lot of variety, so that they need to have all kind of raw material to import to Malaysia. Next, here we will see that the SWOT analysis of Gardenia. The strength of Gardenia would be have a high extensive distribution network. Gardenia have a very good distribution network where they distribute to customer, they distribute to retail, reseller, and a lot of malls. And Gardenia product is able to see everywhere and you can get it anywhere. And next would be wide production line of modern plants facility. Gardenia have few production plant, and Gardenia able to produce up to 150,000 grapes, different kind of grapes per day. And broad product range, it have a good amount of product that can cater to different age group of people, from teenagers to elderly people. And next, the weakness of Gardenia is there's no personal selling. So that the Gardenia is sell through companies or sell through reseller, instead there's no personal selling. And lower quality of product compared to other competitor. So they, in order to cater that many people in Malaysia, from West Malaysia to East Malaysia, they need to hit certain amount of target to cater that amount of people. So they neglect the quality of their product. And next would be weak management. So they have a weaker management team compared to other company, as they very hard to operate on West Malaysia and East Malaysia, so that they need to improve on that. Opportunity wise, a demand of updated breakfast, so that nowadays Malaysian they seek for healthier breakfast, so they prefer good quality and better breads. And positive growth of baked goods in Malaysia. So in Malaysia there's a lot of working class people, so the population of Malaysia eating bread is increasing, so there's a good opportunity for Gardenia to expand their business. And the threat of Gardenia is bargaining power of buyer is high. And next would be currency depreciation in Malaysia. Because as we all know, Malaysian's currency is depreciating. And Malaysia is suffering to buy or purchase goods as they want. And this is their recommendation of just now the SWOT analysis. As we can see, create and develop product that is able to represent Gardenia company and its brand. Because we need to create the product that able to speak for the company itself, instead of we need to advertise. So as people can see the product and they already know that the product is from Gardenia. And next one, we establish and maintain strict proactive practice for safe grain production and suspicion of dirty grain. So Malaysians seek for healthier grain. So we also need to emphasize and to have more clean production of the grain, so that we don't want to have the customer to fall into sick eating the grain or the product of Gardenia. And next, create a new flavor of product and promotion. Gardenia enough to cater for a lot of Malaysian in Malaysia, but they lose out against their competitors such as Bread History, like I said before, a lack of a lot of product. So they need to create new product to attract different taste of consumer regarding. And actually, bundle selling strategy. So the more we can create bundle selling strategy is that the more you buy, the cheaper it is, instead of you buy one and it will be expensive. Next will be wealth management of capital and product, so that Capitea will be able to set up, implement and achieve goal of corporate planning in the future. This is before that I did say that Gardenia have a big management team. So this is able to help Gardenia to strengthen up their management team to build a plan for the future on what are the future planning and what they can improve on and how they're gonna expand their business. And next I'll be handing over to my and target market of Gardenia is customer market. Gardenia always target customer because customer consume their brand. And next will be reseller market. Gardenia also give their product to their reseller. For example, Tesco, Eons, and 7-Eleven also. So that this will help Gardenia to fully distribute their product all over Malaysia, and this their product is able to get anywhere the customer will be. And next, that the segmentation of Gardenia is that the age. So as you can see, there's a young age, the young kids, and there's an elderly person. They also will be consuming bread no matter how old they are or how young they are. And pricing wise. So the pricing will be compared to Massimo and other brands as you can see on the pictures. So this will be the only thing that, that segment them in the brick industry where they need to set their price low so that they will compete with other competitors. Next I will be handing over to
by doing that,
Gardenia Original Classic White Grapes. Meanwhile, in East Malaysia, Gardenia launches a lot of products that are not related to bakery, such as soft drinks, ice creams, and creamers.
Provide a seller to sell their bread to the village so that the residents in the village can easily purchase. clear? Okay. I got a few questions to ask. Okay. Has the branding, Gardner has branding and achievements, any advantage to the company? They also have, like, they have branding and all those, right? Is there any advantage to the company?
Any advantage to the company? Yes. Because as the, these are the achievements that are achieved by the brand. So we're able to further improve their reputation of the brand. And yeah, to be well known to most of the Malaysian.
And from the brand analysis, do you see more Malaysian to buy brand and purchase by them? Do you see? Do you think the products of Gardena is sufficient for now? Or do you think they should create more products to compete with the competitor? You're talking of Massimo and Sobretti, sorry. What do you think?
Actually, I think that they should produce more different ingredients so that customers can have more, they will come and buy more than there is different ingredients.
Do you think they should just stick to bread and create more varieties or they can do it for other ingredients, should be cakes or whatever?
Because for Gardenia, they are good enough to create
concept.
So we think they can stick to bread, but they can produce more new ingredients too.
Okay, come back to yourself, Friday. Is Gardenia's Friday affordable? Do you think I'm Friday? No, no, sorry, your promotion. Do you think it's promotion by Gardenia? Sufficient. Gardner don't really advertise that much, right? Do they advertise that much?
Well, but
so how do millionaires get to know about Gardner? Million generation, they also, how do millionaires get to know about Gardner? What do you think Gardner should do to target million generation? Okay, you're talking about recommendation, right? Million generation, how do you want people to get interested in Gardner? What do you think?
Okay,
come here.